The House and Senate are away from Capitol Hill right now into the brand new year, but impeachment talks do continue this holiday period. Our East Texas Congressman Louis Gohmert right now joining us live in studio with more insights. So welcome back, sir. Always
glad to be with you, Neil.
Okay, so last week, let me tee this up like this. This last week, the impeachment inquiry was going on. I was walking down the hallway here at the Radio Ranch, and I heard your voice on the TV in the green room, so I sneaked in to see what you were saying. About that time, you had stopped, and I thought, okay, I grabbed my makeup bag to go back down the hall, and then all of a sudden, I heard you and somebody else going at it full tilt. Here's what I saw and heard.
This country's end is now inside. I hope I don't live to see it. This is an outrage. I yield back.
Gentleman from New York.
I am deeply concerned that any member of the House would spout Russian propaganda on the floor of the House. I now yield 1 minute to the gentleman from New York, Mr. Higgins.
The gentleman from New York is recognized for... The House will come to order. The gentleman from New York is recognized for 1 minute.
Thank you.
The House will come to order. The House will come to order.
Okay, so left-wing and right-wing media, the national level, had a field day with that. What exactly happened?
Well, he had basically slandered me, saying I was spreading Russian propaganda, and every detail I said has been documented and is true. So that was a ridiculous, false statement he made. And normally, under the rules of the House, if somebody... call somebody out or call somebody a name or says they're doing something that's actually a slanderous statement, then that individual is recognized to demand that the words be taken down. The speaker would not recognize me. It has to be done during that period. You can't challenge later. Mm-mm. The speaker wouldn't, perhaps the speaker knew that he was out of order and I was in order, but she wouldn't recognize me. But I would make clear to him, I was asking if he'd yield first and give him a chance to take those words back.
I think a lot of Republicans were upset the last couple of weeks, alleging that the Democrats were making the rules as they went along.
And basically they were.
So you agree with that?
Absolutely. They did. The rules are very clear. Now, when you're in the majority, you can change the rules, and they've done some of that. But for one example, the rules are that if you were going to turn down the request for witnesses, which Nadler did over and over, you still, under the rules, have to give them a minority day within a reasonable time, and that means before you vote on it. And we made the request for a minority day of witnesses, and he says, you know, maybe later on, but not now. That was outrageous.
All right, moving on now. Lawrence Tribe is a well-known Democrat lawyer, and I've been reading where he has been sort of counseling Nancy Pelosi, and so I was hurting. Hurry up with impeachment. Then all of a sudden, the last moment, we've impeached, and now they're not handing over the articles of impeachment. So what's going on with that?
Well, the speaker is looking for leverage she thinks she has to get the Senate to do exactly what she wants. It doesn't work that way. Once you have impeached, then the trial is in the Senate and you don't have leverage. And McConnell, we've had a lot of disagreements, but he's handling this just right. And now today, of course, comes out the Democrats' attorney is saying we may go on and keep having additional articles.
So what is that all about? Because that news broke late this afternoon saying it all depends on Mr. McGahn's testimony. So all of a sudden they're saying they may be going back to the well for more impeachment.
Right. And so obviously they know they didn't prove their case and therefore it will never go over well in the Senate. So they're wanting to continue this sham effort to impeach the president. It's not going to be successful.
I've also heard this, that unless the articles are accepted by the Senate, that he's not fully impeached. But then again, what are the, a lawyer, what are the official rules on
and
this?
Actually, it could be litigated, but normally, under the when there's rules, precedent.
Yeah.
Rule.
Well, these are Democrat lawyers who said that because one of the men who called the four lawyers that were called. One of them said
Feldman from Harvard.
He was
guy that kept lying and saying I'm very reluctant to mention word impeachment when he's been tweeting about it for 3 years. So anyway, he was dishonest, and it was really unfortunate. But this, it doesn't work this way. No. If you're going to impeach, then let's get it done. Let's get it over with. This is very divisive. And there were some of us that felt like there were impeachable offenses in the Obama administration. But I knew, Neil, that if we pursued that, it would divide this country irreparably. But the Democrats don't have a problem dividing the country if it's they think it'll help them politically.
Some have said that basically when there's a new Democrat president one day, and there will be, the Republicans, if they're majority in the House, need to impeach them to show them not as a punitive thing, just to basically go, you know what, this has to stop.
Yeah.
This has to stop, and it can't be used as
know.
A weapon. That's what they're saying.
I'm not so sure that that's a good idea. I just know that this is an outrageous idea.
We have less than a lot of people have been listening to talk radio. I have. And this has been sort of the you'll call in and tell us what you think. So some folks are saying they want an elongated Senate trial. Yeah. They want to squeeze out every witness. They want to call some people to task. Others say, I think Mike Lee, who is a lawyer, a senator from Utah, he said, I'm an attorney. I've argued cases. When you win the case, he says they won the case, shut up and sit down. So what are you for?
I understand that, and I understand the arguments for just saying they didn't prove it. Let's do a motion to dismiss. But much of America has not followed this close enough. I would love to see the Senate bring in critical witnesses.
You want witnesses.
Fact witnesses, and get them up there because the House didn't allow it, and I'm afraid there'll be people screaming that, oh, they covered up for the president, when the truth is, if we get the witnesses out there, the real fact witnesses, not all this hearsay garbage and opinion, then people will see what a scam this whole thing was.
When should the U.S. Senate take this up in January? When?
Well, as quickly as possible, but it is a debatable point. It could be a litigable point on whether or when the House has to send it down. Do they have to send it down for the Senate to pick it up and have a trial on it? That's never been an issue before because people have never been as irresponsible as Speaker Pelosi is being now.
Mr. Gohmert, thank you for being with us tonight. We appreciate it. Always come by.
I love being
with you. And I know the folks at home, whether they agree or disagree with you, want to hear from you. And you're facing the music.
Well, thank you so much.
All right. Thank you for being with us. And stay with us. We'll be right back with weather.